Just how would you assess the game today? I mean, what was the strategy going in chasing such a big total? Did you believe yourself that you could, midway through innings, that you could actually take the team home?
Answering the first question, when you have 370 odd runs to chase, there's not much plan. It's very clear that everyone has to play with intent and try, because it's big totals, you need to everyone to fire, and plus when in a good run rate as well, strike rate as well, sorry. And obviously when I was batting, we had to believe, and I genuinely felt that we could have done it. It's just that we lost important wickets at the wrong time. Shikhar got out. Shikhar and myself, we had a fantastic partnership. We could have built up from there and maybe had a better shot to get the total. But unfortunately, we lost wickets where I felt we were getting the rhythm.
Just a quick one, Hardik. The fact that you're not bowling much and we don't know when you would be in a position to bowl a lot of overs, does that kind of just give you more freedom with the bat? Like, you know, you're number six, you have a fixed role. And
I'm getting this question for the first time. Generally, it's the opposite, where people ask me that it does it put more pressure on my batting. But as you mentioned, yes, I'm working on my bowling. I'm going to come at the right time when it's needed. It genuinely does not make much difference, because I believe in both skills, which I do. And I like to back myself and have that confidence where whatever role is given to me, I try to fulfill at my best as ability. And as a batter, then I start thinking as a batter. I try to take the game deep. I try to bat in a way where I can score more runs than what I'm used to. So it does not add much pressure, or it does not give me too much freedom, but I just that I'm enjoying being on the ground as a batter or as a cricketer.
Can you just tell us, where do you stand in terms of resuming bowling? Because you have been like undergoing rehab and stuff like that. Can you tell us where do you stand in terms of resuming bowling?
Where I stand?
Yep.
It's a process. I'm looking at a long-term goal where I want to be, 100% of my bowling capacity for the most important games, which are the World Cups are coming, the most crucial series, whenever it's required. But I'm thinking as long-term plan, not short-term plan, where I'll try to exhaust myself and maybe have something else which is not there. So it's going to be a process which I'm following. So I can't tell you exactly when I'm going to bowl, but the process is going on. I'm doing in the nets, I'm bowling. It's just that I'm not game ready, but I'm still bowling. And it's all about confidence, and the skill has to be at the international level.
Oh, no problem.
Thank you.
Rest of the people, please mute yourself.
Do you think that India is missing an all-rounder to fill in like a fifth bowler's role, sixth bowler's role, somebody goes for runs, like what happened today with Chahal? We didn't have anyone who could come in as a backup bowler. You had Australia, Marcus Stoinis got an injury, but Maxwell could come and pitch in. So do you think with your absence, and do you think that there is going to be some extra bowler that will be played next in the next game?
Yeah, that's been the question always, right? We have to find and maybe make. I always believe that even when I came into the circuit, I was not always the all-rounder which I wanted to be. But with time, I groomed myself and became that bowling option. I worked on my bowling. I worked on my batting. And it's always going to be difficult when you go with five bowlers, because then if someone is having an off day, you don't have someone to fulfill. More than injury, it's about the six bowlers' role. Is always about if someone is having a bad day from the five bowlers, they come and fill those overs, so the other guy gets more cushion. I think it's going to be maybe we'll have to make, or maybe we'll have to find someone who has already played India and groom them and find a way to make them play.
Journalist who's first.
Maybe you can name it who all are there.
Hardik, aap bata sakte ho ye jo bubble to bubble kaisa raha din aapka, aur kitna tough padta hai ek player ke liye quarantine, and how things go about
if you can take us that route, 14 days quarantine, फिर दुबई से आना, फिर ऑफिस क्वारंटीन होना, कितना मेंटली है ये पूरा प्रोसेस पूरा?
Difficult obviously है, but I think as professional cricketers we think that we feel that this is the best opportunity, or we are actually lucky that we are able to play this sport. So I know 14 days, genuinely, if you ask me, it's very difficult because you don't know, you are not allowed to do lots of things which you are used to doing. So it has been difficult. We did, I think, 14 days for IPL. Prior to that, joining the IPL team, we had to do, I think, a week or 7 days there quarantine, then coming here and having quarantine here. I think difficult, but then luckily we got through with it, and I think we as players are just lucky. We feel the best way to go about this situation is that we feel that we are lucky that we are playing this sport right now. Whatever is happening, things are difficult in the world right now, but I think we are able to play the sport. That is the most important thing.
हार्दिक मेरे भाई, शादी हो गई, बाप बन गए, क्या फर्क पड़ा है इसका? कुछ शांत हो गया हार्दिक पंड्या?
आप बताओ कैसा लग रहा है आपको दूर से देख के?
बढ़िया लग रहा है।
नहीं यार, मतलब फीलिंग थोड़ा डिफरेंट है, ऑटोमेटिकली हो जाते हैं सर। आपने भी मतलब ऑब्वियसली जब बच्चा होता है तो ऑटोमेटिक थोड़ा और काम होते हैं, यू थिंक अबाउट लाइफ इन अ डिफरेंट वे. And I think my perspective towards my family has changed. As a person, I have changed. And I think the change has come for better. Miss kar raha hu abhi jaane ka, waiting for... abhi jab 15 din ka tha, usko chhod ke aaya tha. Abhi 4 mahine ka ho jayega jab wapis jaunga. To things, kaafi cheeze change hui hai, lekin bahut behtar ke liye hui hai. Aur sabse best time tha life ka.
Thank you, everyone. We've come to the end of this press conference. Thank you once again for joining with us.
Thank you. Dhanyawad.